is up, guys? Thaddeus here. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day. In today's video, I'm actually gonna be showing you guys my best-selling products for literally an entire year, right? And if you guys know me, if you know who I am, my name is Thaddeus, and I got started dropshipping in the fashion industry. So with that being said, my top-selling product was this. Okay, now, I didn't actually post those pictures, like that kind of image, right? Because again, that's a white background image. If you guys know me, again, I preach content. Content is king, guys. Literally, I'm jumping right into this video. No fluff, no whatever. But like it and subscribe okay, do that. Basically, guys, what I did, right? What I did separately from my competitors, what I noticed that I could do better was content, okay? So again, this was my top-selling product, all right? You see it? These were my top-selling products, right? But these were the pictures I posted, okay? Now, that shows you guys the power of content, all right? Now, what does that mean? So basically, with my funnel, how I generate traffic and whatnot, most of my traffic starts with Instagram, okay? Most of the time. What that means is I'm driving, you know, either like influencer shoutouts or even Instagram sponsored posts in some cases, just to drive traffic, right? I wanna start building up pixels, like starting to build that content so people view my content, view the products, you know, start to check out, add to cart, all this kind of stuff, like even purchase and stuff like that. But it's a matter of just getting traffic, getting relevant traffic, getting interested traffic in the product. Now, what I wanna get with content, right, is that a lot of the times you, okay, I'm assuming some of you guys at least watching this video, don't, like, you aren't very good photographers.
Hey, that's a half truth.
Or you don't know very good photographers, or you just don't have really good images to post of your products, right? So you're stuck with these AliExpress images, you're stuck with, you know, the supplier images, like white background images, pixelated images, like these crappy images that, yes, you can get sales with, okay? I've done that before when, like, I have no content and I was first starting off in my very, very, very first stores and, you know, every once in a while I posted that, right? Again, you can convert with those. It's not a problem. But again, if you have your own content, right? If you have your own content, you're creating your unique branding, like, appeal around your company, okay? That's how you can convert. That's how you can actually build an audience and build people that think, hey, this is an actual unique brand, all right, that I can actually purchase these products from. It's not like another, you know, dropshipping site, or it's not another one of those sites, right? Because again, these products are not like really, really rare, okay? For instance, right, I'm in the fashion industry, so I'm selling, you know, shades, bracelets, hats, whatever it is that people wear, okay? Stuff like that, and my battery's about to die. Okay, round two. And we're back like 3 hours later, guys. My battery died and I couldn't find my spare charger, so I had to charge the battery up. So it's currently 4 in the morning and I'm gonna film this video, finish it for you guys. But again, guys, I wanna go back to this. The key to actually generating sales, right? You can sell anything. Like a good marketer can really sell any product.
Sell me this f***ing pen right here.
Okay. The key to it, right, is your website, the traffic you're bringing in, how you're bringing it in, and content, right? And the reason I say content, again, is the most important thing is because content plays a factor in everything else you do, guys. It plays a factor in your website. It plays a factor in your social media, right? Which is how you're getting traffic for the most part. It plays a factor in your paid ads, like what you're actually showing consumers or interested clients to actually get them to click through to your website, to add to cart, to convert. It's content, right? It's how your brand is perceived. What do people think of your brand? If they think you're a $5 brand, then you're worth $5 then. If they think you're a $500 brand, you're worth $500 then, guys. It's all like psychology and marketing and content, okay? So again, that is literally the key to a lot of sales and the reasons why you guys just can't get sales, okay? Again, I'm not just saying like, hey, if you got really good pictures, then, you know, you're gonna get a bunch of sales now, because that's not exactly how it works. But again, if you have complete control of your brand, right? Because again, I'm a control freak when it comes to my businesses. I want complete control over how my brand is perceived to clients, okay? To clients, customers, right? So again, if I have my own content, right? Everything on my website is my picture that I have decided that I want to show to the people seeing my website, okay? Everyone visiting is seeing stuff that I already know and want them to see because it's my decision to actually showcase these certain pictures, okay? Everything on social media is pictures that I have curated or I have had, you know, my photographers or myself have taken with these products, with these lifestyle stuff, so that people, like, when they view my social media, when they view the content, when they view anything related to the product, they feel a certain emotion, they feel a certain lifestyle, right? They see themselves with the product, right? Again, this works really well for fashion because, again, if you're selling a fashion, like, product, right? The reason why I don't just have a white background image with the product, right? Is people want to see themselves in it. They want to see what they might be doing with it, guys. It's a lot of lifestyle stuff, right? Which is why, again, in all the pictures, you guys will see that it's not just the product that's like the main focus most of the time, okay? That relates to lifestyle. It's like, hey, when you're wearing a bracelet, when you're wearing this bracelet, what do you envision people doing, okay? So yeah, that's why content is so important. That's why when you market this stuff, you can basically push off that emotion, that character of your brand into this, into your marketing to bring people in, right? So it's not just a random product that you have to make sure that it's an impulse buy for most of these people. You can actually showcase a quality product and a quality brand that attracts people to it, that piques curiosity and actually gets them to want to buy the product. And yes, you can capitalize on impulse buyers with this and bring in a unique traffic source that actually, you know, like enjoys the quality branding, enjoys the actual brand itself, and they perceive your brand as something much higher than everyone else who's dropshipping, you know, at this level doing the same crap, right? So guys, that's the basis of it. It's just like, man, that was my first dropshipping like products that literally made me money for an entire year. I sold the crap out of those. Again, I had shades, I had wallets, I had phone cases, I had all this kind of stuff, like hats, whatever it was, but bracelets sold the most for me. And I think that's because I did a really good job of showcasing the lifestyle, right, within the content, and then pushing that out to people, right? Because again, you can have good content, but if no one sees it, right, it's like your website. You can have the best website ever, but if no one sees your website, if you can't bring traffic to it, you're not gonna make money. You can have the best content ever,